welcome to another episode of Vanilla Superflat Survival. And oh my god, there are just so much slimes outside, and it's raining, and soon mobs are gonna spawn. Thankfully, I have the feature to turn off music and sounds to hostile creatures to 5%, so I wouldn't have to hear them slapping, because let me just turn it back up and show you how loud they are actually. Yeah, that's a bit annoying. I'm gonna have to turn that down. So anyway, like I said in the previous episode, I did mine a lot of cobblestone. You probably noticed that I already have a crap ton of cobble just inside my hotbar here, but just take a look at my inventory. This is definitely enough cobblestone to build a huge fortress surrounded by cobblestone walls so that slimes can't get in. So in this episode, what we're gonna do is we're going to actually build my house and fortress that's slime proof, and just to prove to you that I did not actually hack the cobblestone in, because it is very easy to go into creative inventory and just collect all the cobblestone I need. However, I made this from this cobblestone generator right here, and I can prove to you that I did not hack them in by going to my statistics and blocks. And as you can see, I mined cobblestone times mined cobblestone. I mined it 2,119 times. So yeah, I actually did mine it, and I did this all with just stone picks. As you can see, I still have some stone picks right here. And what I think I'm going to do is I need to go and find a place where I can actually build my house. There's a lot of slimes here, and it is going to be a bit difficult to actually build my fortress since the slimes are going to be in the way. So I think I'm going to have to do it quick, and I don't want to take too much cobblestone with me just in case I get blown up by a creeper or something. And let me just see and check if it's daytime or not. Yeah, I have no idea if it's daytime. I think it might be nighttime. Well, what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to craft a bed, and even though I said that I'm not going to sleep in the series, I think it would be much interesting just to sleep the night just so I can skip it, because we're going to have a day of building. Let me just craft a bed real quick out of these wool pieces that I got from the lampposts. So let me just place the bed down here, and we're just going to sleep real quick. And one thing I forgot to mention is that I surrounded this whole area. I just broke the walls here. I surrounded this whole area with cobblestone to make sure the slimes don't get in. I also connected this house. This used to be a small house, which is not connected with this blacksmith's house. So I just connected them together, and I placed the cobblestone generator here. And another thing what I did is I actually sacrificed a piece of obsidian. As you can see, I only have 3 pieces of obsidian now. I sacrificed a piece of obsidian in order to have obsidian there, because what I do is I actually just I set like a weight on my mouse so I could AFK cobble. So I did kind of cheat, but I guess, well, it was still mined correctly, and I still used pickaxes. I still have to like switch the pickaxes. It's not fully automatic. I'd call it like a bit less than semi-automatic. So anyway, let me. So now that I've slept and now that it's daytime, what I can do is I can maybe I'll just grab some more picks. So what I'm going to do is the first order of business is I'm going to craft some fences, and I'm going to need a lot of cobblestone fences. So there we go. Just got a few stacks of those ready. And what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to set down. I'm going to place all the cobblestone inside here just in case I get killed by slimes. And I already made a mistake of putting too much stuff into my inventory, because as we know, I got blown up by that creeper. And I don't remember if it was the previous episode, maybe the episode before that. I kind of forget. So anyway, I'll just take a bit of... Oh, that's weird. They should be in one stack. I'll just take half of my carrots just for food. Let me just eat some. And I'll depart for... and find a good area to build my house. Let me see. So I somehow have to get out of these slimes. Let me just jump on here. Just parkour this. And yeah. Goodbye, slimes. Oh, I think they're going to start spawning here again. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to probably build my house somewhere around here. There doesn't seem to be any slimes actually spawning here. So I'm planning to have 3 high fences. So let me just start right here. Oh, a slime spawn there. Okay, so we should not build there. Like I said before, it would really suck if we actually built my house and mansion on a slime chunk, because then the slimes would actually be able to spawn inside. Also, a slime spawn there. Well, if slime spawn there, then that means this isn't actually a slime chunk. Well, it looks like the slimes are kind of gaining on me. I should have brought at least some blocks just to evade the slimes, because if I do go on top of this fence, I am able to evade the slimes. So like I said before, okay, there are a crap ton of slimes here. Okay, so I used a stack right here. Let me just use another stack. So I know that I'm making my just enclosement area really large, but I do actually need a large area for my mob grinder, for some farms, for just for a bunch of stuff, because I'm planning to have a mob, a breeder, an iron farm somewhere here, so I'll have to build a pretty large mansion to accommodate for all of that. Okay, so this isn't good. Nope, 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 nope. Oh, I just glitched out for some reason. Go away. I wish I had a sort of knockback, because knockback is much better than actually killing the slimes, because killing the slimes is difficult. Okay, I just placed the wrong piece right there. Okay, where are my, okay, I think that the big slimes are gaining up on me. It's okay if I have some slimes enclosed in here, it's not too bad. Yeah, this is a bit worrying. Yeah, I don't like all these slimes here. They could be a very dangerous thing. Okay, so maybe I'm gonna trick the slimes. Let's see. Okay, so the slimes are pretty slow, so it's actually very easy to run away from slimes. As long as I kill the big ones, it's actually not that difficult to run away. They're just getting in the way of building, which kind of sucks too. So anyway, so I'm not gonna. I'm just going to build as fast as I can, because I don't wanna spawn the slimes, because the longer I am in one area, the more vulnerable am I to slimes, because that's actually how they spawn. So yeah, I think this is going to be my enclosure. Yes, I am probably going to have to have I'm probably going to have to craft much more cobblestone fences than that. However, I have a pretty large supply of cobblestone, which is not a problem. I might craft a bit more. And as you can see, I don't like to stay in one spot for a long time, so what I'm doing is I'm just building one layer of the fence right now, and I'm going to build a layer, a second layer later. I was actually planning to make it 3 tall, but I don't know, if I have extra spare cobble, then that might... Okay, I already hear some large I already hear some large slimes. The large slimes are actually very slow, which is an advantage, so I can knock back. I'm gonna knock you back a bit further and then just keep on building this. Oh wait, did that just spawn there? Because if I built my house on a slime chunk, that probably really sucks. And it's very difficult to actually get slimes not to spawn, because slimes can actually spawn on torches and during daylight, so I think that might be quite a large issue. And looks like I got it correctly, so now I just have to stack a second layer here. Ouch! Didn't expect that. Well, that's not a really big slime, so no problem. Let me just get this piece. I think that I left some pieces there too, and just to test out if this is a slime chunk or not, I think I'm going to kill off all of the slimes and just observe the area. Yeah, this isn't something good. So at least when I kill off these slimes, it's going to be difficult for the slimes to get back in, unless of course this is a slime chunk. Okay, now this kind of sucks. I only have one sword with me, so I should have brought more, because these slimes, they need lots of swords, and they deplete my swords very quickly. As you can see, just look at my durability bar and how quickly it falls. I definitely need more swords, so let me just kill off the rest of these right here. It's a pretty great XP farm, but a big nuisance. I hate slimes. It's funny how in the regular world, like in a vanilla world, which is not a super flat world, slimes are actually very sought after, because getting slime balls is very difficult. However, in a super flat world, these slime balls are no use. They're cheaper than dirt. Like dirt is more expensive and prized than these crappy slime balls who no one needs. Looks like I need to replenish my health, just regen real quick. So I'll just kill off these slimes there and then see if any additional slimes spawn. If any additional slimes do spawn, I'll have to fence off the chunks. And I know how to go into the F3 menu and look for the for the chunks. Oh, well, that kind of sucks. I'm going to have to kill them off. The small slimes are actually very easy to kill with hand because they're just one hit kill. But the bigger slimes actually do have to be hit several times. And the medium ones do have to be hit several times too. So there's three types of slimes, as you probably know. Well, there's the extra large one, like the really large one. Well, I just call it large because that's the only large slime. Well, there's also the medium size slime, and then there's the small slime. So slimes can cause okay, let's see. Can they jump over the fences? Yeah, it looks like it's okay. Looks like there's not much slime spawnagers around here. So yeah, I can see quite a bit spawning there, or they're just going here. So let me just dismantle all this. Oh, those just mistakes on you. Let me just build a second high wall. So what I'm planning to have is a system of underground tunnels, maybe an underground subway once we get an iron farm going. But of course, for an underground subway, we will also need some redstone and wood and also gold for the powered rails, so that could be seen as an issue. Let me just knock him back, because when he's here, it's hard to build, so knock back, then just keep on building here. Yeah, unfortunately, it's difficult to build when the slimes are here, because the slimes accompany a piece. Oh, I ran out. Okay, did that one just come through this hole here, or did it just spawn here? Because it would kind of suck if it did. Oh, you can see sometimes the XP falls on top of the fence. Okay, let me just run real quick. I think that I better put a hole somewhere in this fence just so it'd be easier to run away. Okay. Let me just run real quick back to my base here so I can craft some more cobblestone fences. It actually looks like this village is now completely destroyed by the zombies and mobs. Yeah, unfortunately. Oh, no. No. Oh, and also I have a secret passage. I also have a secret passage, as you can see. If I break it right here. So I basically built an underground tunnel here so I could access the my base through the ground. And it's actually a very great idea because the slimes can actually swim, so it's quite easy to access my base from the ground. That is just so I wouldn't have to deal with the slimes, just in case. If you're playing Superflat, you have to actually have underground passages to avoid slimes, because it's almost impossible to get out if there's like 10 big slimes, because they'll just kill you in a matter of seconds. So anyway, I don't really care about the slime balls. If I lose them, I'll just leave them in my inventory here. I could always get more, and I always have a lot in Superflat Survival, because obviously I do have to kill off the slimes. So anyway, let me just craft some more fences here. Or will this be enough? Oh, no, unfortunately that is not enough. I'll just need one more stack. Yeah, the cobblestone goes pretty quickly, but I did generate a lot, because I think it took me about like 10 pickaxes. Oh, actually, let me check. So let me just place that right here. I can go into the statistics menu and actually look at how much pickaxes I crafted. So let's go to items. Stone pickaxes, so I used up 23 pickaxes so far. Oh, actually, no, I depleted 16 pickaxes, so I think I used around 15 picks to create all of the cobblestone seen here. So I'll just take some cobblestone just in case if I ever need it. I think this cobblestone wall will be enough just to build a second layer. However, if I do want to build a third layer, I will probably have to have more. Oh, it looks like it's nighttime now. So, okay, am I on hard because I don't see really any mob spawning? Actually, these slimes have a positive effect because the slimes actually take away the spawn rates from other hostile mobs. And wow, that's a huge base. So eventually, I think I will plan on deconstructing the whole village just so I can break off the whole village and so I don't have to look at it. Yeah, this is exactly what I'm worrying about. Slime spawning inside my house. As you can see, there's a slime jumping in there because it just spawned inside the house itself. This parkour around here. Anyway, so I'm just gonna sleep real quick because I'm building right now. So where is it gonna say? Oh, Yeah, actually, for some reason, slimes don't count as hostile mobs, because sometimes if you're really close to mobs and you want to sleep, it says that you can't sleep because there are mobs around you. But if there's slimes around you, that doesn't count as hostile mobs being around you, which is kind of weird because they're still hostile. Let me just jump down real quick here. Yeah, it looks like my build was pretty successful because I don't see any slime spawning. Yeah, I actually did see some slime spawn over there. Yeah, I'll have to keep track of that. Let me just crit those. Oh, I really should have brought with myself a sword or something, because I can see that Spidey over there. Yeah, I don't need spiders here. I think those slimes actually did spawn inside the enclosure, so that is something to worry about. What I think I'm going to do is I'm going to... Okay. Okay, I'm going to have to crit this. Okay. Okay, I hope he doesn't kill me. Then there's also slimes pursuing me. I really should have brought with myself some swords, because this is not working out. Finally. Okay, I hope there's no slimes behind me. Oh, great, because then I would probably died, so, yeah. Okay, let me just regen some health right here. And so what I'm going to do eventually is, at the end of the episode, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to, let me just block off this hole right here to make sure no slimes get through. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to stand somewhere around here and make sure that there's no slimes actually spawning here, because it would really suck if there's slime spawning here. And if I do see slime spawning, I'm going to go into my F3 menu, and then where it says, I think... I'm not really sure where the chunks are. I think it says where BL. Oh, no, actually, it's where... Yeah, I forgot. I actually used to know... I used to know in what F3 menu it says the chunks are, because if I do find a chunk where slimes spawn, I'm just going to close the area off to make sure that the slimes don't spread to other areas. Yeah, these large slimes are making it very difficult to build my wall, because as you can see, I'm just trying to left click, but they sometimes take piece of the... So I'm just gonna hit them back like this and just run to make sure they don't catch up with me. But of course, they will eventually catch up with me, so... just close that free menu just so that I wouldn't annoy you. So anyway, I'm planning to have just a regular house. I'm not the type of Minecraft builder that likes to build like really beautiful or aesthetically pleasing houses. I'm more into the technicality of Minecraft, so a very, very like old and dilapidated cobblestone cabin will do as my main base for me, because I don't really care about looks, I just really care about functionality, because if something in Minecraft is not very functional, but is just only made to look aesthetically pleasing, which means to look good, like, but not have any technical purpose, I don't actually like those builds, because those builds don't really add anything. Like, builds that don't have any technicality to them, any builds that don't actually add, like, that don't have any technical use but are only made to look good, I don't really like those builds, because I think, in my opinion, it's just a waste of resources. Especially early game now on, when I'm building my first base, I think that it would be much better to not focus on aesthetics. I think that I only focus on aesthetics... Oh my god, when I'm gonna finish this. These slimes are everywhere. God damn it. So I only focus on aesthetics when I'm like late game, because that way, that's actually when I focus on aesthetics, because when I have a lot of resources and I don't really have anywhere else to put the resources to, I start focusing more on looks. But now, since I'm building my first base, I might as well build it only to be technical. So it actually looks like I still have some cobble left over. I'm not sure, but just to make sure that spiders don't get in or anything, I think that I'm going to actually build a third layer. I think I'm going to run out of cobble, unfortunately, but let me just build a bridge. I hope that this will be a bit easier to build. Okay, so let me just build one here. Yeah, this isn't working out very well. Unfortunately not. Looks like the big slimes are still making it difficult for me to build up this wall, because the slimes, as you can see, sometimes... Ouch. Because as you can see, the slimes, they sometimes take up an area of the block. That's why it's impossible to place it. As you can see, I just placed one. I'm just left-clicking, and it sometimes just does not build. I know that this three-tall wall might be a bit overkill, but it's actually not that overkill considering that during nighttime there are mobs here, and a crap ton of mobs, and spiders, and jockeys, and during the daytime there's just endless mobs. Oh, I just got scared. Oh, I see, that's where it turns. So anyway, so like I said before, this is actually a very dangerous area to live in, like just the super flat world, because during the nighttime there are constant mobs and spiders and jockeys, and as we know, spiders can jump these walls pretty easily, so it's good to have tall walls. Another thing is that during the daytime there's constant threats from slimes that always pile up on here, so that's why I also want a three tall wall. However, a too high cobblestone wall will also actually serve as a good enough wall to prevent the really, really tall slimes from jumping through, but I just don't really want to look at the slimes because this wall also is aesthetically pleasing because I'm not able to see the slimes as well, and I don't really want to look at the slimes jumping up and down all the time. So I think this has been quite a short episode, but just because I feel like I have achieved a lot in this episode, I'm going to cut the episode fairly soon, just as soon as I finish building this wall. And one area of worry is that I have not actually lit up the area correctly, and I will need a lot of torches, so I think during the nighttime a lot of mobs will spawn here, so the smart choice would be to actually sleep in the bed, because sleeping in a bed, the mobs don't spawn, it skips the night and no mobs actually spawn. Like, if you go to sleep right at sunset, mobs, like when mobs haven't spawned yet, but when you can sleep, then that's when actually it's really easy to avoid mobs. But I don't like making it easy, so I think I won't sleep, but I might sleep, I don't know. Just depends on, yeah, it looks like the sun is setting. Well, I wouldn't say I have that little wood. I think I might go and collect some more wood to make torches so I can light up the area, because I am going to need a lot of torches. I'm thinking about 2 stacks or so, or 3, so that means I'm going to need 32 charcoal, so that means I'm going to need to convert 32 logs into charcoal, and that's not counting the wood that I need for fuel, because I don't have any other fuel except, ouch, yeah, I would have to regen, because I could die easily like that, so yes, as you can see, a 3-high wall definitely protects me from slime attacks. And I haven't made any gates yet. I'm going to make gates right here pretty soon, so just to make sure that I'm able to go out. However, I don't know, because I think that making gates wouldn't be so efficient, because I'm going to build, underground tunnels leading out to, outhouses. I'm going to build some underground tunnels leading out to the houses there. I'm going to build an underground tunnel from my base over there to this base right here, just to make sure, so I can travel very easily, and also, if I don't want to avoid slimes, I can actually build, I don't actually have to build underground roads. I can build, roads on top of the terrain, and I will just have to make sure to build 2 high cobblestone walls so that slimes can't get on the road while I'm there. And that's also how I'm going to build the rapid transit system of boats, the boating system. The rapid transit system of boats that will lead to other villages. I'm soon planning to, as soon as I find the original village where I spawned in, and where my original base of operations was, that's where I'm going to build a rapid transit system through several villages, and I'll be able to travel very quickly, and I'm going to have to surround the whole transit system with tall fences to make sure that slimes don't interfere with my transportation system. Yeah, I'm kind of running out of carrots right now, but that's kind of fine because I'm almost done. I really hope I'm gonna not run out of cobblestone wall, but it does seem like... Oh, actually, no, I'm not going to run out. I still have a stack left and quite a bit. It's great to have more left over. Cobblestone walls are always important in this super flat world because, obviously, slimes are a nuisance, so I do try to... use cobblestone walls. Some other people like to use wooden walls, but I still like to use cobblestone more, and because wood has other uses. So let me just deconstruct this here, and wow, it looks like I'm done. So Yeah, I don't know how I'm going to do this. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to just run somewhere and then just deconstruct it. I'm going to run here and then make sure that slimes don't touch me. Just come out of here real quickly. And just run real quick just to make sure that I avoid the slimes here. And wow, this is a pretty nice structure. I'm so looking forward to building a great base here because I won't have to deal with these slimes anymore. Oh yeah, is that my oh yeah, that's where my current base is. So, oh, I don't have any. Unfortunately, I don't have any access right now to collect. Okay, go. Yes. Okay, now I'm gonna sleep real quick. And like I said before, I actually did say a long time that I wouldn't sleep in a bed, but I just think that just because I'm early game right now, I don't really have anything else to do, and I just really don't want any mobs spawning there, so let's see. So like I said before, I'm going to have 33, I'm going to have to put out 32 wood in order to, all of this wood, I'm going to make it to charcoal so I can light up the whole area, so this is how much wood is going to go towards charcoal. And I'm pretty sure I have some furnaces here. Yes, there we go. I have a furnace right here. I'm just gonna place. Yes, I'm gonna place a furnace here. Just it's a nice little corner area, just commons area. So I'm just going to convert the oak wood into some planks. And what I'm also going to do is I'm going to actually use my fences and oak wood planks, oak wood stairs. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my stone axe. I think I'm going to make just a bit more sticks. So I can make some more tools just in case. Like I said before, I do have to make two more swords to fight against slimes, and the slimes use up the swords pretty quickly, so I'm also gonna build, I'm also gonna craft another stone axe. Place the furnace back inside here, so I'm gonna go outside, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to mine some of the areas here. Like, I think I don't really need any of these houses, so I guess I'm just going to deconstruct them. And I really do need the wood for charcoal and everything. Obviously, I do have my saplings, but I have not built an industrial wood farm yet, so I will have to deconstruct the houses. And then otherwise, I mean, there's no villagers living here, and otherwise, nobody really needs these anymore, so... Oh, I'm standing on top. That's weird. Okay, let me just deconstruct this. I'm going to deconstruct this as soon as... So as you can see, the big slimes can't get to me right now. Well, yeah, they can hit me, but like I said, they can't get to me. Yeah, I'll try for them not to hit me. Oh, just lost that piece there, unfortunately. Yep. Oh, just got that piece there. So yeah. So yes, unfortunately, I unfortunately, the slimes do seem to be getting to me. So Oh yes, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to deconstruct this piece here. Place a cobblestone here. Just break this glass pane here. Nobody needs that glass pane right here. Just place a cobblestone here. I do actually want to leave some... I do want to leave quite a bit of the... I want to leave quite a bit of the houses just to make sure that... I have the houses to jump on just to make sure, because I like to do parkour and stuff just to get out, because I can't really get out of this area while I'm cornered by slimes. Looks like I'm kind of losing lots of the yeah, I think I'm going to abandon this project soon, so this is going to be an issue. So what I'm going to do is I'm probably going to just make a bridge right here so I can get back right here. I won't bother collecting that piece of wood there. Nobody needs that, so yeah. Yeah, they deal quite a bit of damage, so... Well, I've got 30 oak wood, so I guess that's not an issue. Let's see, how much charcoal... Oh, wow, it's still going. That's not bad. I thought I was going to need more fuel than that. Let me just dump in more fences here. And I got the oak wood stairs and the pressure plates to go. So, I'm going to have to eat some carrots just to make sure I don't... just to make sure I don't starve. And so I can regen, so... See, I might deconstruct this house too, because it has quite a tall roof, and it's great that they make all the roofs out of these logs, because that way it's much easier to collect all of the wood. And obviously I like logs much more than just wood planks, because logs are much, well, logs are more useful, because I can make four wood planks out of one log, which every Minecraft player should know, of course. So anyway, I'm going to deconstruct this, and then I'm not going to go any lower than that because I'm once again scared. Yeah, they're kind of getting to me a bit, so yeah, that's not good. I'll have to wait until I regen. Or should I just kill? Okay, you know, I'm just tired of the slimes. I'm just gonna kill them. I'm only gonna kill the really large slimes. I'm gonna leave off the medium sized slimes to make sure that, because the medium sized slimes don't deal as much damage and are easier to kill. So, oh, I almost just shot over there. Nope, lost that piece. So let me just get over here. Yep, seems like my work is done here. Let me just build another. Okay, can they touch me from here? Okay. Looks like I built a bridge and I have enough oak wood. So I think this episode has been long enough. I'm going to do some other work on the on my base. I'm going to collect much more cobblestone so I can build up my base even greater than before. It seems that we have been very lucky and no slimes are spawning inside because it's not located on a slime chunk, so we won't have to deal with the slimes anymore, definitely. This is Mike Kralix. See you all in the next episode. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Thank you very much for watching till the end. This was Mike Kralix. Expect more videos, and I'm out. See you all in the next video.